Yeah, I think one reason why we are debating this whole thing is there's a full squeeze on revenues, you know, because basically there's no spending happening. You know, I don't think this would have been a problem in 2007, you know, 2006. But basically what is happening is the entire revenue is now getting squeezed, you know, and that is why we are having this whole debate. I think the whole, the entire assumption behind GST was that it would lead to a huge buoyancy in revenues, you know, then the states don't have to, so you had first the 42% formula, you increase the devolution from the center. And the second was GST. And let's not make a mistake. Every state supported this. Okay. Now there's no point in saying that it's not there. And many states, many states said that, you know, since it's destination based, so therefore we'll all benefit. Okay. So I don't think anybody thought through this thing completely. See, on paper, something like GST makes absolute sense. You know, I mean, it's a wonderful thing that, you know, there should be no cascading. You know, and at each level. So suppose I'm suppose I'm making saris in say Surat. So the power loom guy, you know, he makes the he buys the yarn, he pays the tax, then he makes the white cloth, you know, and then he pays tax on it, claims credit, and then that goes next to the guy who's dyeing it, and then that fellow then pays tax, he then this thing. So the entire thing was based on an assumption that, you know, there'll be a fantastic system where immediately you will have you know, all these things. You'll have tax whatever this thing at each point, you know, your input tax credits you'll get, and it'll be a seamless kind of a system. Whereas what has happened is probably we are having one of the greatest deindustrialization maybe since the British times, you know, what we are seeing today. You know, industries are closing almost by the minute, you know, I mean, and everywhere, and jobs are disappearing flies and mosquitoes kind of a thing. So in such a scenario, nobody is spending. There is no spending. When there is no spending, there is no revenue generation, right? And initially everybody thought, you know, that the formal sector will benefit. Whereas, without realizing that even ultimately a Hindustan liver and all is ultimately selling to somebody who may have been earning his money earlier in cash, you know, who would have been, and there was a lot of cash which was rotating within the economy. Today, now there is no circulation of cash, there is no spending, and this is a classic recession, you know, and which India has never seen, you know, a demand constraint. This has never been a demand constrained economy. For the first time, we are seeing real estate prices fall. Again, now we have to see, you know, what is the proportion of, stamp revenue and these kind of things? How much is the earnings to the states? All these are being squeezed, you know, and on the other hand, they are trying to raise revenues by all other kind of things. Like for example, now in UP, now they've just raised power tariffs by about 12% at this time. You know, I think the minimum power charge now in UP is, I think, now 7 rupees now, you know, which is unimaginable. So you'll find all these new kinds of it's not only the center which is going to try to protect its revenue turf through all these new surcharges. I am sure even states will try and work out some ways of raising revenues and all. And these are going to happen at a time when you are going to have continuing to have a spending compression. You know, so there will be a private. The private spending compression is already happening. You know, and on top of that, you are going to have even the government's compressing their revenues. So I think this entire finance commission terms of reference, all these things have lost complete relevance today, you know, because we are in a completely new kind of a thing. The GST, the compensation was supposed to be, it assumed a 14% revenue growth. What is the revenue growth now? 4%, 5%? Where is the money going to come from? So I think this is a very serious thing. You need to go, as I think TK was saying, you need to think beyond just whether this one particular surcharge. It has to do with a whole lot of things. What is going to happen spending? What is going to happen in the next 2 years? I think we need to look at the short term. This long term and all is not going to work. What is going to happen? You know, so this goes much beyond the Finance Commission. Thank you.